Hi there, and welcome to the SiteGround Website Builder. I'm Erin, and in the next few minutes, I'll show you around your new workspace. We'll cover how to navigate the builder, where to find your design tools, and how to bring it all together, so you can feel confident every time you log in. Let's dive in. When you first open the SiteGround Website Builder, you'll see a library of professionally designed templates. Take a moment to scroll through and preview the templates. Each one is built on clear, proven website structures and is fully customizable. You can choose one that matches your business type, but don't feel limited by that. You can make any template your own. If you'd rather start from scratch, just scroll to the bottom and select blank site. That option is always there, but for most people, starting with a template makes the whole process faster and easier because you don't have to build each page section yourself. The layout, structure, and content blocks are already in place, so you can jump straight into customizing. Once you've made your choice, just click Customize and you'll enter the builder. Now that you're inside, let's break down what you see on the screen. On the left is a sidebar where you'll find access to your website content, navigation, files, and style tabs. In the center is your canvas where you build your site in real time. And above is the top bar where you can preview and publish your changes. Let's start with the Style tab and the left sidebar where you'll find your global design controls. Here, you can choose a color palette from our design-ready ones or create your own. Pick fonts for headings and body text. And adjust shapes for buttons, forms, and other elements. All of these style updates apply site-wide, so your design stays consistent across every page. Now, let's move from setting the style to building your content. Right at the center of your screen is your canvas. This is where you visually build your pages. Every page on your website follows a basic layout structure. The header is here at the top. It usually includes your logo and main navigation. The footer is right at the bottom. It's a place for key links, social media, or legal disclaimers. And everything in between is your body, built out the sections. To add one, just click Add Section right in the canvas. This opens a library of pre-made layouts organized by purpose, like intro, about, gallery, and more. Once you've added a section, the left panel automatically updates to show the editing tools specific to that section. Each section comes with its own editing features. You'll find general settings at the top for color and layout adjustments, followed by content settings that let you show or hide individual elements like images, buttons, or text blocks. And if you look at the right side of your screen, you'll see the quick actions bar from where you can move sections up or down, or you can access more options via the three-dot menu. Once your sections are in place, you'll likely want to start adding your own content. Let's begin with images. To change any image, just hover over it, click Update, and select a file from your file center. This is where you'll upload and keep all your media files. And if you don't have any, you can browse our built-in Unsplash gallery for high-quality, free images to use right away. You can also access your file center at any time from the left sidebar here. With your visuals in place, let's move on to editing text. Click directly on any text in the canvas, and a floating toolbar will appear above it. This is where you can adjust formatting, including things like font size and alignment. And if you need a little writing boost, just click the AI icon in any text area, type what you're trying to say, and it will instantly generate suggestions you can edit or use as is. It's the fastest way to get your ideas flowing and your content ready. Let's keep going by styling your header and footer. These appear on every page, so it's worth making them match the rest of your site. To access their settings, you can click directly on them or go back to your content tab and access them from there. In your header settings, you can choose color, adjust the layout, and make the header sticky so it stays visible as you scroll. This is also where you can upload and size your logo, as well as add a favicon. In your footer settings, you can set the color, show or hide your logo, easily add social links, and include details like copyrights or policy links. Once you've customized a few sections, you'll probably want to add more pages. let's open the Content tab in the left sidebar. This is where you manage all your pages. To create a new page, simply click the New Page button. You'll see two options. Start with a pre-designed layout like Contact, About, or Team, or go with a blank page and build it from scratch. Every new page you create is saved as a draft by default, so nothing goes live until you're ready to publish. Once added, your page will appear in the Content tab, from where you can see your live pages, which are already published and visible on your site. Draft pages, which are still in progress and only visible to you. And Global Settings, which is where you'll find your header and footer settings, as well as your optional Coming Soon page. Need to duplicate or remove a page? Just click the three-dot menu next to it for quick actions. And see that gear icon? That opens your page settings. From here, you can change the page name and URL, set your SEO title and description, and choose how the page looks when shared on social media. This is also from where you can set your page to draft or make it go live. Once your pages are in place, it's time to connect the dots by building your site menu. You can do that in the navigation tab here on the left. Alternatively, you can also just hover over your navigation right on the header or footer. Notice the blue border that appears around your menu. Just click inside and it gives you direct access. To add menu items, I'll click New Item. Here you've got a few options. You can link to any page on your site, link to a specific section of a page, link to an external website, or create a label to group related links. Choose whether the item goes in your main navigation or footer links and click Add. You can also drag and drop items to reorder or nest them under parent links. Let's wrap up our tour with the top bar. Click Site Admin to access your settings, analytics, and marketing tools. Next to that, you'll see a drop-down menu with a full list of your live and draft pages, making it easy to switch between them as you work. And here, you'll find the desktop and mobile view toggles. By default, you're in desktop view, but click over to mobile to see exactly how your site looks on smaller screens. The preview button here lets you check your site while you make changes before it goes live. Or you can preview your live website, which is the one that your users see. And when you're ready to push your changes live, you can simply click on Update. You'll see a window pop up from which you can choose exactly which changes to push live. Just check the boxes and click Confirm. And if you ever need help while building your site, just click the question mark icon to open the Help Center. You'll find popular topics and instant answers from our built-in AI assistant right inside the builder. And that wraps up our tour. You now know how to move around your website builder, where to find your tools, and how to start bringing your website to life. Whenever you're ready, jump in and start building. We can't wait to see what you create.